Makanya Tasya apuan who glorifies the Lord. Ride accept. Yat by whom? Shanaha time. Nitaha utilized. Uttama soka the all good personality of Godhead. Bhartaya in the topics of translation and purport by divine grace Abhay Charana Aravinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Sri Prabhupada Srila Prabhupada ki translation. Both by rising and by setting the sun decreases the duration of life everyone except one who utilizes the time by decreasing except one who utilizes the time by discussing topics of all good personality of God. Please repeat.
Both by rising
and by setting, the sun decreases the duration of life
of everyone
except
one who utilizes
the time by discussing topics of
the all good personality of God.
This verse indirectly confirms the greater importance of utilizing the human form of life to realize our lost relationship with the Supreme Lord by acceleration of devotional service. Time wait for no man. So, the time indicated by the sunrise and the sunset will be uselessly wasted if such time is not properly utilized for realizing identification of spiritual values. Even a fraction of the duration of life wasted cannot be compensated by any amount of gold. Human life is simply awarded to a living entity, Arjiva, so that he can realize his spiritual identity and his permanent source of happiness. A living being, especially the human being, is seeking happiness because happiness is the natural situation of the living entity. But he is mainly seeking happiness in the material atmosphere. A living being is constitutionally a spiritual spark of the complete world, and his happiness can be perfectly perceived in spiritual activities. The Lord is the complete spiritual world or spirit world, and his name, form, quality, pastimes, entourage, and personality are all identical with him. Once a person comes into contact with any one of the above mentioned energies of the Lord through the proper channel of devotional service, the door but the perfection is immediately upon you. In the Bhagavad Gita 2.14, the Lord has explained such conduct in the following words. Endeavors in devotional service are never baffled, nor is there failure. A slight beginning of such activities is sufficient even to deliver a person from the great ocean of material fears. As a highly potent drug injected intravenously acts at once on the whole body, the transcendental topics of the Lord injected through the ear of the pure devotee of the Lord can act very efficiently. Oralization of the transcendental messages implies total realization, just as fructification of one part of the tree implies fructification of all other parts. This realization for a moment in the association of pure devotees like Sukadeva Goswami prepares one's complete life for eternity. And thus, the sun fails to rob the pure devotee of his duration of life, insomuch as he is constantly busy in the devotional service of the Lord, purifying his existence. Death is a symptom of the material infection of the eternal living being. Only due to material infection is the eternal living entity subjected to the law of birth, death, old age and disease. The materialistic way of pious activities like charity is recommended in the Smriti Shastra, as quoted by Srimad Chakravarti Thakur. Money given in charity to a suitable person is guaranteed bank balance in the next life. Such charity is recommended to be given to a Brahmana. If the money is given in charity to a non-Brahmana without Brahmanical qualification, the money is returned in the next life in the same proportion. If it is given in charity to a half-educated Brahmana, even then the money is returned double. If money is given in charity to a learned and fully qualified Brahmana, the money is returned 100 and 1,000 times. And if the money is given to a Veda Parag, one who is factually realized the path of the Vedas, it is returned by unlimited multiplication. The ultimate end of Vedic knowledge is realization of the personality of God. Lord Krishna has stated in Bhagavad Gita, Veda ischa sarvair aham eva vedyo. There is guarantee of monies being returned if given in charity regardless of the proportion. Similarly, a moment passed in association of this pure devotee by hearing and chanting the transcendental messages of the Lord is a perfect guarantee for eternal life, for returning home to God. Madhyamagatva punarjanamana vidyate. In other words, a devotee of the Lord is guaranteed eternal life. A devotee's old age or disease in the present life is but an impetus to such guaranteed eternal life. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Om jnanati mirandhasya jnananjana salakaya chakshurunmilitam jena tasmai shri gurave namaha. Shri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Gadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam. Vande Aham Shri Guru Shri Duta Padakamalam Shri Guru Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathamitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Rupam Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Rishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Sesaha Sunyavadi Asya Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gauravise Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Neena Bandhu Jagatpate Kesa Gopika Kanda Radha Kanda Namaste assembly of this Jama Loka and after 66 years. So everyone thinking our child, we are growing and we will enjoy this world. But actually, this fact, anyone just, I ask, sometimes we walk, we ask someone, how are you? And he tell, yes, I am okay. And I am okay, yes. But actually no one is okay in this mental world. Everyone is suffering. After creating this material world, the creator put signboard. What is signboard? Dukkhalayam aswasatam anityam asukharogam. And we are forgetting to see the signboard. What is the nature of this material world? Krishna is telling anityam asukham lokam imam prapya bhajasuma. So my mother, you are born in this material world, but you should understand that what is the nature of this material world. This is temporary and this is miserable. You may try with all effort to get happiness, but it is never possible. This is the nature of the material world. But still, we are thinking, the conditions for thinking to enjoy this material world. Because he is part and parcel of the supreme enjoyer, Krishna. Satchidananda Vigraha. So being part and parcel of the Supreme Lord, because he is topmost enjoyer, supreme enjoyer, so we are also thinking we are little enjoyer. We can also enjoy. But this is not fact. One can enjoy by connecting himself with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. When you cut off this connection and independently try to enjoy, it is not possible. That's why it is spoken in Bhagavatam. Jatha karomula nisechanina trupyanti tatskandha bhujopasakha pranopuharena jatha indiyanam tathaiva sarvahana archutejya. Sukadeva Goswami giving a nice analogy. Jatha karo mula nisesha. If you want to see a tree full of very with green leaves and flowers and fruits, and what you have to do? You have to pour water at the root of the tree. If you want to see yourself in a healthy body, then you have to supply food to your stomach, to your belly. Similarly, if you want to be actually pleased in this material world or to be happy in this material world, then you have to satisfy Achyuta, Krishna. Jasmin tushte, jagat tushte. Unless you are able to please the Supreme Lord Vishnu, there is no other way that you can become happy. This is the only way to become happy. If you engaged in devotional service. So that's why this verse is very important verse. That by both rising and setting, the sun decreases the duration of life of everyone. Everyone. No, there is no Prabhupada writing in purport. The time and tide wait for no man. It always goes on decreasing our life. So, but one who utilizes the time by discussing topics of all good personality of Godhead, Vishnu, his duration of time is not decreasing. How it is? Everyone's time is decreasing. How it, time is not decreasing of a devotee who is always engaged in hearing Krishna Katha? Everyone has to die. Jatasya hi dhruva mrityu. You have taken a bath and one day you have accepted this material body and one day you have to leave this material body. So how he said that the duration of life is not decreased of a devotee. How it is possible? Actually devotee also die. And materialistic person also die. But Prabhupada gave example of a cat. Death is what? Like a cat. The cat sometimes catches the kidney, taking one next to other, own child. Transferring. How is he carries the child? With her mouth. Same kidney. Sorry, same cat. Sometimes so grab a mouse. So what? Situation of the mouse. Mouse is just just second, topmost and painful condition. But what is the situation of the kitten? He is happily just happily just thinking, my mother is taking to me a better place. Actually, now this like supreme personal personality of Godhead, he is immortal. So all living entities are also immortal, being part and parcel of supreme Lord. Mama Ivan Sadiva Loge Jiva Bhuta Sanatana is also Sanatana. But falsely, we are identifying ourselves with this body. That's why thinking, we are attached to this body. So we don't want to give up this body. That's why, unless we get to that to pain to the extent of research in Shastra, 10,000 scorpions biting you at the same time. Unless you get to come to that point of painful condition, no living entity want to leave this body in condition of that. But a liberal says, a devotee, he don't care for death. Rather, he invites death. Dhruva Maharaj, when death personified come in front of him, told Dhruva, now your time is, come to leave this body and go to, according to your give a small service, you are supposed to return back to Godhead. So please give up this material body. Dhruva Maharaj even did not listen to the personified dead, personified death. He put his feet on the head of death and just flying with him. But aeroplane that has come to receive him from the Vaikuntha planet, from Dhruva Maharaj. So a devotee never fearful. He knows this is death, is death is also Krishna. Kao asmin lokakhaya prita prabuddha prita yukita. Krishna is telling in Mahabharata when Arjuna saw this universal form and he became very fearful. And oh Lord, who are you? I am very much fearful now. Lord told, I am time. Kala asmin loka khayagya prabhudhai, and just like this bar system, the time decreases the duration of life of everyone. But devotees know this, but devotees becoming rather they are thinking, in this lifetime I must utilize my whole time for hearing and chanting apart from the pure devotional service. So he never cares for death. Rather he was thinking, when this time will come, I may leave this body and enter to the spiritual planet, eternally serve my love there. So devotees never fearful of death. Rather, the only the conditioned souls, those who are so much entangled in this material world, falsely bodily vision, they are remain always fearful. So Uttama Sloka Bhakta, this verse is telling that Tasyata Yat Khananita Uttama Sloka Bhakta, who utilizes his time by discussing the topics of all good personality of Godhead, their lifespan is not decreasing. So that is the real goal of the human beings. Otherwise, ahara nidra bhayamaitunancha samanyaleta pasuhi naranam dharma tu eka adhika visesa dharmena hina pasuhi samana. Ahara nidra bhayamaitunancha, everyone is doing in 84 lakhs of species. All the living entities in any body, they are doing the same thing, this fourth thing. What is the speciality of a human being? Dharma tu eka adhika visesa. Dharma. A human being can follow the principles of religion. Dharma tu eka adhika visesa. Dharmena hina What is dharma payment mean? What is the real dharma of the living being? Jivera Swarupa Hai, Krishna and Nitya. You understand? His own Swarup. Then I am eternal servant of Krishna. Then, after understanding this, what is duty? To serve the Supreme Lord. Kehu mane, kehu na mane, sabitar das. Jehu na mane, apana gune, sehi jaye nas. Vrindavan Das Thakur, speaking in Chaitanya Bhagavad. Someone is recognizing or someone is not recognizing the Supreme Lord. But everyone is eternal servant of Supreme Lord. Those who are recognizing their position as eternal servant of the Lord and engage themselves in devotional service, their life become perfect. And those who are not recognizing this, the thinking, I am independent. Iswara aham, aham bhogi, siddha aham balavan suki, like Hiranyakashipu or Ravana. Sahi jaye nas. Then he is definitely destined to be destroyed. So that is depend upon us what to do. The real dharma of a living entity is Nitya Dharma. There are two types of dharma, Nitya Dharma and Naimittik Dharma. Naimittik Dharma is to look after this body. And because we are in this human form, how can we perform devotional service? We have to look after also. This body, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to say, you must maintain a healthy body. Otherwise, how can you perform devotional service perfectly? But that is Nitya, that is Naimittik. What is Nitya Dharma? Eternal duty is to serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So how the service started? Navadhabhakti, by the principles of devotional service, ninefold. Savanam kirtanam vishnu smaranam padasevanam archanam vandanam dasyam sakhyam atmanivedanam iti pumsarvita bhaktischat navadhakshanam. How can we connect ourselves with the Supreme Lord and serve Him? Process is given. First process is savana, hearing. And for this Kali Yuga, specifically in this Kali Yuga, these two processes most important. Savanam, kirtanam. Chanting and hearing. Then we come to the stage of remembering. The real goal to achieve is to remember Krishna all the time. Smartabhya satatam Vishnu, Vismartabhya najatuchit, sarva vidhi nishadhesu edoyar eva kingdar. Whatever we are doing, following all these rules, regulations, whatever we are doing, what is the goal? Always remember Krishna, never forget. At any time, death will come. Kamala dala jala jivana dala mala bhajau haripada niti. This life is just like a drop of water on a lotus leaf. It just any time it will fall down. So that is the goal, to remember Krishna all the time. There is one small boy in Puri, his name was Gopal. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very much like that boy. And he was always moving around Gauranga Mahaprabhu. And one time Mahaprabhu was just entering to bathroom or something. Then he is not talking, putting his mouth. Then this boy is telling, why you like this, not talking? I told I have to, going to pass away or something. He told me, so death can come every time. So what will do? If you someone is in the bathroom and is passing time or passing school or doing anything like that, put his head. And death will immediately attack him. What he will do? He will talk that time. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him, now you become my guru also. So that boy, from that day, Mahaprabhu told him from today, your name is Gopal. You are not, you are even teaching me that any time one is to chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This is new year or this is old year? Old every time. A devotee has to chant 24 hours a day, all the time. Remember Krishna. Always remember Krishna, never forget Him. This process, but to remember Krishna, we start from chanting. Chanting the name of the Lord and hearing. That's why this verse is giving so much importance. Discussing topics of all good personality of Godhead. That is the nature of a devotee. Who is a devotee? What is the qualification of a devotee? What is the definition of a devotee? Lord himself gave the definition in Bhagavad Gita, 10th chapter, 9th verse. Matsita madgata prana bodhayanta parasparam kathayanta shamam nityam tusyanti cha ramanti cha. The devotee. Matsita, his mind is always fixed at lotus feet of the Lord. Madgata prana, his life is completely dedicated for the devotional service of the Lord. Madgata prana. Bodhayanta parasparam. Kathayanta samam. When a devotee meet together, one devotee meet another devotee, what is the topic they discuss? They discuss only Krishna katha. No other topic, no other discussion. Just like businessman, Drupal gave example, just like businessman. Meet another businessman. So they talk about business, about their personal business, about money matters, about so many things. But when a devotee meet each other, what is duty? Who is a devotee? Bodhayanta parasparam, kathayanta samam nityam, de nityam, all the time. They talk about me, like a mad man. They get pleasure by talking about Krishna. Prabhupada wrote in Purport about Krishna's name, his qualities, his pastimes, all these topics. They discuss when the devotees get together, they discuss all these topics. Bodhayanta parasparam kathayanta samam nityam tusyanti ramanti. Why they are talking? Because by discussing these topics, tusyanti, they get ultimate pleasure. That's why they are always engaged in such activities. How they get pleasure? Prabhupada gave the example in the verse. Just like in material world, in material sense, a young boy and a young girl, they are always hankering how to meet in a secluded place. They love when one young boy and one young girl, they love each other in material sense. And when they meet in a secluded place alone, they become very enchanted. Similar, this is a crude example, but devotees, they get happiness even 1,000 times more than this pleasure, this material pleasure. So that's why devotees are always engaged in talking about Krishna, hearing about Krishna. From whom we can hear? From a sadhu. Avaishnamba mukhat kirna kuta hari katha amitam savanam naiva kartavyam sarpo chishta jatha. You may hear this Krishna katha but not from the non-devotees. Just like milk is like nectar, but when the serpent or a snake just touch the milk, drink little person, then the milk become poisonous. Similarly, even this is Srimad Bhagavatam, but even if it is recited by a professional reciter, then it is not give any effect to develop devotional service. That's why Bhagavata Padhadiya Bhagavata Sthani. Ekanta Sarana Raha Govinda Charane. That is the statement of Swarupa Damodara Goswami, secretary of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It will you have to hear Bhagavatam from a Vyakti Bhagavat, this book Bhagavat. Bhagavat is two types. This is Granta Bhagavat and a personal Bhagavat. How can one understand this book Bhagavat when he hears it from a person Bhagavat? That's why here in Naimisharanya, this 60,000 disciples is there awaiting to listen Krishna Katha from Sutta Goswami, who is a Bhagavat. And similarly, so there are so many sages come, but Parikit Maharaj is hearing Krishna Katha from mouth of Sukadeva Goswami. Similarly, in whole ISKCON, we are hearing Krishna Katha from the mouth of Srila Prabhupada by reading this Bhakti Vedanta Parampara. So, reading regularly Srimad Bhagavatam, specifically the Bhakti Vedanta Parampara, we are associating with Prabhupada. So, this is the way. And one has to hear regularly Nityam Bhagavata Seva. In this material world, we are seeing everything with this material eyes. But when you want to see a sadhu, how can you see? Through ear. That means you have to hear from a sadhu. That's why in this verse history, those who are engaged constantly hearing this Krishna Katha, they are actually making their life perfect. They are not subject to this rule. Ayu harati vai, unsa udaya, astam chat asav. They are not subject to this rule. Because actually no, but this living entity is eternal, is not subject to death. His artificial thinking, I am dying. It's because he is attached too much to this material body. So when one understands this truth, and he engaged himself in serving the Supreme Lord, in the association of Vaishnavas, when devotees, then his life become perfect. So, for a devotee, whether he dying or living, the same. Prabhupada used to say this story. One sadhu saw different types of people. And when he saw a prince, then he gave the blessing. What is blessing? Chiranjeevi Babu, Ayushman Babu, he may live long time. Then he saw a Muniputra, a Brahmachari. He is doing nice devotional service. He gave obeisances to the sages, then he speaking. Then the sages told, okay, Majiva, you should not leave anywhere, die immediately. Because now you are pure, your consciousness is pure. You are performing devotional service. Who knows, after you may be like Ajamila or something. You better to die now and you return back to Godhead. Then he met another person, a butcher, cutting animals, killing animals. He told, Majiva, Mamar. You should not die, neither live, neither die. If you die now, immediately the Madhutas will catch you. Give you so much punishment in hell. And if you live, then again you continue cutting animals. So both is not good. That's why if you die or you should not die, you should not live. Then he saw a devotee. What is the blessing? Jivova, Morova. For a devotee, both is same. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to say, he regents him who thinks a devotee dies. A devotee never dies. That is not, this is for actually, eternally, everyone is a Krishna's part and parcel. Everyone is Vishnu. For a Uttama Adhikari Vaishnava, he sees everyone is Vishnu. But this living entity due to his conditioning nature, he is not thinking. He sees a devotee. But who has accepted this path of devotional service, for him, there is no death. Even if this, whenever he is living in this material world, in this body, he is engaged in serving the Supreme Lord. And when after leaving this body also, he will engage in devotional service in spiritual planet. So that is the goal of life. There is no other way. And how can we achieve in this age, this goal? By chanting and hearing. Krishna sudham upagate dharma gyanadibhi saha Kalau nashta dusa mesa purana varka aduna when Krishna left this planet enter his Goloka Vrindavan planet then to fulfill the place of Krishna what is he left this Srimad Bhagavatam Purana take the place of Krishna so by regularly hearing and reading Srimad Bhagavatam nashta prayasu avadresu all the unwanted things will be cleansed within our mind and gradually we will progress in the path of devotional service. Reading Srimad Bhagavatam and same Bhagavatam is telling Kalo dosa nidhe rajan asti hi eka mahana kirtana adhiva krishmasya mukta sangha O King Parikit, Sukadeva Goswami is telling in this age of Kali everything is bad. There is nothing good in this Kali. Kalo dosa nidhe Nidhe means ocean. This Kali Yuga is ocean of bad things. So, but there is one good quality. What is this? Kirtana Eva Krishna. If you chant and glorify Krishna, Kirtana Eva Krishna Mukta Sangha Paramunaje. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Chanting Srimad Bhagavatam and chanting Hare Krishna Mantra, there is no difference. Who is the Acharya? For nine Anga, there is nine limbs of Bhakti. For every limb, there is one on Acharya. Who has perfected that particular limb in their devotional service. For Shravanam, who is there? Parikit Maharaj. Kirtanam, Sukadeva Goswami. Vishnu Smaranam. Prahlad Maharaj, Savanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pada Sevanam Lakshmi Archanam Prithu Maharaj, Bandhanam Akrur Archanam Bandhanam Dasyam Hanuman Sakyam Arjun Arsubala Siddham, all these covered by us Sakyam Atma Yubidhanam Vali Maharaj He gave everything So the first who is the Acharya for Savanam Kirtanam? Parikit Maharaj and Sukadeva Goswami. What they are hearing and what they are chanting? The Acharya for Kirtan is Sukadeva Goswami. What you are doing Kirtan? You are chanting Srimad Bhagavatam. And hearer is Parikit Maharaj. But same chanter is telling that Kalodha to chant also Hare Krishna Mantra. Kirtanadeva Krishnasya Mukta Sangha Parangrajan. The concluding verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, when Sutta Goswami concluded Bhagavatam, the concluding verse of Srimad Bhagavatam is telling, Nama Sankirtanajasya Sarva Papa Pranasanam Pranama Dukkha Samanam Tangamani Harim Param Nama Sankirtanam So the Goswami is closing this Bhagavatam, telling Nama Sankirtanajasya Sarva Papa Pranasanam. Nama Sankirtanam by chanting, congregationally, loudly, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. By chanting this Mahamantra, Nama Sankirtanajasya Sarva Papa Pranasanam. One can free from all sinful reactions. Nama Sankirtanajasya Sarva Papa Pranasanam. Prana Dukkha Samanam. By paying obeisance to the Supreme Personality of Godhead Vishnu, one can make himself free from the punishment of Jamaraj. Saman. Tam Namami. I am paying my obeisances to that Supreme Lord and glorifying his name. I am closing this Bhagavatam. So that is the only way in this material world, in this age of Kali, there is no other way. That's why he told, Iti surasakam namnam kali karmasanasanam nato paratara upaya sarva vedesu prasyaya. All Vedic literatures, this is it here. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama Iva Kevalam, Kalau Nastai nasteiva, nasteiva, gatiranyata. There is no other way, there is no other way, there is no other way. Hare Krishna,
Krishna,
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. We want to become happy, then always chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Any question or comment?
Yes. Hare Krishna. Maharaj, it's told that hearing Srimad Bhagavatam and chanting Hare Krishna is same. So why don't we chant Srimad Bhagavatam? Why are we chanting Hare Krishna? Chanting both of them is same, so we can chant either of them.
Yes, whatever you like to chant. Who is prohibiting you to chant?
We are told to chant Hare Krishna.
Chanting Hare Bhagavatam, then there is no chanting of Hare Krishna. We stop Bhagavatam and chanting Hare Krishna.
Yes, we can do only one of these activities.
Yes, why can't we make him so perfect by chanting one of them? Okay?
But because we require that, that's why we are doing it. We require both of them, that's why we are doing it.
Yes, Rupa gave us both, so follow the Acharya. Okay? Hare Krishna. Any other question? This is charity. I didn't because in the end of the Bhagavad Prabhupada told about charity. I wrote about charity. Jat karosi jadasnosi jat josi jadasi jat jat tapasvesi kaunteya tat guruswa adarpanam. In Gita 9:27, yes, Krishna told. Whatever you are doing, jat karosi jadasnosi, whatever you are eating, jat karosi jadasnosi jat josi. Whatever giving in charity, that dadasi, necessarily whatever you have, giving as a gift, dadasi, it's giving as a gift. That karoshi dadasi, that tapasvesi, whatever austerity you are performing, do everything as an offering unto me. So charity in Bhagavad Gita is described different types of charities. Charity is in tamaguna and rajaguna and also in sattaguna. So there is a brief except because today new year many people give charity. Yes? But Krishna is telling don't give to other. Give everything to me. We are coming to you, we are going to your friend's house. Today you are you are taking some gift. But when you coming to Krishna's house, this temple is Krishna, temple. You must give something to Krishna. Not something Krishna, you can give everything to me. Tatkurusa madarpanam, whatever you giving in charity or gift, you give everything to me. If someone is in a mood of ignorance and he is taking a bath, rather than giving some money to these beggars, then what will that beggar will do? He will do tea stuff. Chai. Chai. The money means support. Chai. Then, when he more money, then he will buy some cigarette, smoke, or drink tea. And even more money, then he can go to liquor shop. So, like this. So, you are giving this charity. According to Shastra, 1/12th person of this charity, whatever he is spending, if the charity, but this money, how he is spending, you are also will get the effect for that. He is doing some sinful activity, then you are also responsible for that. You are also responsible for that. Okay? So if you give the charity to an unqualified person, so what will happen? You also go to heaven. That's why Prabhupada giving the example how to give a charity to a Brahmana. If we give to a Brahmana, who is born in a Brahmanical family, but he is not actually qualified Brahmana, he is a Brahma Bandhu, still, in next life, you will get the equal person of amount of the money, whatever you give. But if you give to a qualified person, to a Brahmana, then it will like 100 times return, you will get return. But if you give to a more qualified Brahmana by when this thousands time, times more, you can return in next life. But if you give everything to Krishna, then Krishna will take you to return back to Godhead. So Krishna is telling, give everything to me. Jat jadasi, jat tapasis kante, tat kruso madarpanam. Give everything to me. Krishna is not demanding to give. You have to give either to a Vaishnava who will take the money and utilize it for Krishna service, or to Krishna directly. Then that is the real purpose of charity. Otherwise, it will give to unqualified persons, and he also entangled for his karma. So don't give charity to unqualified person. Of course, Gita is telling, Krishna is telling in Gita, there are two types of charity, vastu dana and jnana dana. But which is more important? Jnana dana. Giving something to feeding someone, giving some vastra, someone, there are so many things you can give. But if you give him Bhagavad Gita to someone, then no one can compare, no charity can be compared to that when you give him a Bhagavad Gita. In Ekadasi, in Purnima, in some special days, when Gita Mahatma says, to give a Gita, or Srimad Bhagavatam, or someone, then you will be qualified to return back to Godhead. So everyone has to give some charity. It is not prohibited. I am a devotee, I will not give charity. If you will not give charity, then you will not also get anything, even if you go to the spiritual world. Among this, so many Ekadasis, one Ekadasi, Saktila Ekadasi, Saktila Ekadasi. But in the Mahatma, as you are old lady, you are patroning all the Ekadasis, Nirjala, remaining awake whole night. But one thing strange in his character, he never give anything charity. And Dwadasi is supposed to feed Vaishnavas, Brahmana, then he has to take prasad. But he never feed anyone, never give any charity. So the Lord himself thinking what type of devotee he sees, such doing so much austerity, not even drinking water, remaining awake 24 hours a day chanting my name, but he is not feeding anyone, not giving any charity to some. Lord himself came as in a Brahmana form, in a old Brahmana, and taking a pot, just appeared on Dwadasi day morning, asking Mataji, Hare Krishna. Then again his son asked her, so he became angry and came in angry, and he was just cleaning his house with gold and what? With cow dung and some mud. So he brought all this cow dung and mud and put it in angry mood on the pot of the Brahman. He is the Supreme Lord in the form of Brahman. But Lord took this cow dung and mud and he made a cottage in Vaikuntha Mahalakshmi. When our time duration is over, then because he performed so much austerity, so Vishnu Pradas came and took her to Vaikuntha Mahalakshmi. And they told, pointed out this cottage is for him. And when cottage, but there is nothing for eating, no bed, nothing for him, for her enjoyment. When he started crying, shouted to Lord, I performed devotional service for whole life. I did all I can see. Nothing for my enjoyment. Lord told him, very grieved. Well, because if you have not given any charity to anyone in your lifetime, because if you did my personality, my devotional service, that's why you came to Vaikuntha world. Now you can go down again and perform another Ekadasi, Saktila Ekadasi, that is. And then when the demigods, sometimes wives and demigods come and knock your door, then you give them charity, give them charity, all this. And by that charity, then you will get again everything for your enjoyment. That's why Krishna told in Gita 18th chapter also, you must give charity, do not stop these activities. There are so many stories in Shastras. If you not give charity, then your life is also useless. Padma Purana, there is story of Maharaj Maharashweta. He was a big king. He performed so many jagyas, so much austerity, everything. But in whole lifetime, he never gave any charity to anyone. So when time, the death came, because he was performing karmakanda jagyas, he went to Brahmaloka, where Lord Brahma is staying in Satyaloka. But Lord Brahma told, okay, by your austerity, finances and jagyas, you come to my planet, but you never given any charity. So you did not get anything for eating. You did everything just to make your body very sound, healthy. So you have to eat this your own body. I will make your this material body in such a condition, it will not spoil. Every day from Brahmaloka, you have to go to the Sanskrit planet and eat this body, your own body every day. By eating your own body, we put to your stomach. That is punishment. Then this Maharaj Shweta started crying. So, what can I do? And Brahma told, okay, Agastya Muni come one day to you. When you are just going with this heavenly aeroplane to reach that dead body, and when you are eating this dead body like a jackal or a duck, then he will come. Agastya Muni will see you in distance. Then will stop you. Stop! Who are you? You are looking like a demigod and you are eating the dead body. What are you doing? When you stop, then you understand, he will say, great respect. And whatever ornament is in your body, take everything together and give in charity to us. Get permission. Then you come back and you get the opportunity to stay in Brahmaloka and get all the facilities. So that's the glorification of charity in many places in Shastra is explained. So you have to give some charity. In this material world, at least those who are grahasthas, that is their duty to give some charity to Brahmanas, to Vaishnavas. And those who are brahmacharis, they give whatever they collect. They give everything to Guru and Krishna. Brahmachari, Guru Kule, Vasandanto, Guru Ritam. For Guru, for the satisfaction of Guru under the brahmachari. Maintain this body. And whatever you collect, as alms, you give to Guru. Okay? Hare Krishna. Is already time? Any comment? Yes.
Charity we collect,
you will use it properly. That's why you are telling that your charity to be given to the Vaishnavas. That's why Prabhupada giving the Sukhamas. To give to Vaishnavas or directly to the Supreme. To give a devotee, who can, you are convinced that this devotee will take this charity and he will utilize this charity for the service of the Supreme Lord, for preaching. The best activity is preaching for the Supreme Lord. Na chatasman, manushya su kaschin vedhi vittama. Krishna is telling, no one is more dear to me than a preacher. Who is preaching this message of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Jare dekha, tare kaha, Krishna upadesh, amar agyaye guru haya, tara idesh. This is the ultimate instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is none other than Krishna himself. Gandhara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.